Michigan has been an advocate for LGBT issues for 20 years. His journey started in college speaking to classes and organizations, and now he is a national leader, lecturer, and advocate on LGBT issues to colleges and universities. Greg is in the middle of his 2011-2012 lecture tour addressing current issues of equal rights for all, bullying, and inclusive communities. So it is a pleasure for me to welcome Greg Baird.
As anybody that you'll meet and come across to on your daily ventures when you're out and about, it's really important that you share your story with people. A lot of us hold prejudice against different kinds of communities, of things that we were taught in our past and how we feel about different kinds of communities. I am one of those kinds of people that grew up in a small community such as yourself, where you were taught one thing, and then when you got a little bit older, you found out a lot of those things were put down your cell phones, put down your iPads, turn off the computer, sit down and have a conversation with somebody face to face and share your story. We are not doing that anymore. And if you're wondering why people are living in fear and they don't understand about different people, it's because we're not talking anymore. I believe the computers are great and we can chat online as much as we want. You know, I could be a hunky bodybuilder online and great look and be whoever I want on the computer. And a lot of people are doing that. Go on the computer one day, go on the chat line, see how many lonely people there are out there. We're not connecting. And the more that we connect and we share our stories, the more that we're going to understand who we are as a people. And you'll be able to understand more about the LGBT community. You'll be able to understand more about the Black community. You'll be able to understand more about different religions, which are very important as well.
So I'm standing at the bar, it's packed. It's a Friday, you know, dinner time, packed. And my bartender friend is over here, the manager, and I'm standing there, and the governor's walking out, you know, and the security guys are going out. And Bogoyevich turns around in the bar, and he goes, "Hey, Greg," because the gay pride parade's coming up, and I told him I was going to be at the gay pride parade, because he told me he was going to be in it. He turns around in front of the whole restaurant. He goes, "Hey, Greg, I'll see you at the gay parade." And the guy at the bartender goes, "How awesome is it that the governor of Illinois just outed you in front of everyone?" And I ask all of you, whatever your background is and whatever your beliefs in, educate yourself. As I tell our gay people, tell your stories, because you know what? Our history for the LGBT community is not going to happen by going to a classroom rarely. It happens by us sharing our stories and talking about different events like Matthew, like talking about Stonewall, Harvey Milk, things like that. We need to share our stories and keep those things alive, because it's important as we get older in understanding that. And also know that the elder LGBT community were once activists as well. Gay or straight, we have a really bad situation in the United States on how we treat our older generation. If it's not new and improved, we're going to get rid of it. Well, you know what? Sit down and talk with, doesn't matter if it's gay or straight, an older person, find out their life and what they're about. The elder LGBT community is a wealth of information, because they've been there. They've fought for a lot of things that we can have now. And I value that. I really value that so much.
So today we had our first big event with Rainbow Alliance. Greg Baird came to speak. Everything went above and beyond what my expectations were. We had a crowd of more than 50 people. Greg's speech was well prepared. He made a lot of excellent points about Matthew Shepard, about the importance of education in schools now, about bullying and the effect that's had on schools, and how we can improve schools by being more educational and more proactive. And I think Rainbow Alliance is headed to great big things, and I'm really excited for the future of this group.
Today was a very great day for Kankakee, as Greg spoke and
we got a good gathering and positive feedback, and he definitely spread awareness to a lot of local youth to this community college, and I think it was just great all around, and I'm looking forward to what the group is capable of and what I myself am too. So I was definitely very happy about it, and just remember that it really does keep getting better. It really does.
The speaker that we had today, Greg Baird, he talked about a lot of various things, but they all tied in together to make a really good message. I've been in this area all my life. Obviously, I've been gay all my life, and I've had the pleasure of not ever really having to run into homophobic things or have homophobia thrown at me, but I think in my life I've changed a lot of people's minds once I came out and they see that we're not some weird creatures, and I think Greg really touched on that we're normal people that live normal lives, and we just live one part different from everybody else, and that love is love and it doesn't matter. So it was a really good speech. I was really glad that I was able to come, and I was glad that we got him here, and hopefully this can be the start of more people coming in and doing speaking here to eventually go out into the community and not just here at KCC. So
no matter what race you are, what religion you are, you're just a person. And Greg, and I totally lost my train of thought back there, sorry guys, but you know, he's entertaining, he's engaging, and I really like that. And just watching him speak reinforces the point that labels aren't important no matter what you are.